آقای رئیس، خانم وزیر، دوستان، آقایان و خانم های نماینده محترم در این جلسه، با سلام بر همه شما. برگزاری این کنفرانس همزمان با شدیدترین حملات سیاسی و تبلیغی آخوندهای حاکم بر ایران علیه پارلمان اروپا است که بنبست اساسی این رژیم و ناتوانی آن را در همراهی با موازین بین المللی منعکس می کند. این حملات هیستریک و افسار گسیخته به خصوص در یک هفته گذشته علیه پارلمان اروپا، آن هم به خاطر قطعنامه این پارلمان علیه نقض حقوق بشر در ایران، نشان می دهد که حقوق بشر پاشنه آشیل رژیم دیکتاتوری مذهبی حاکم بر ایران است و جام زهر حقوق بشر برایش صد بار خطرناکتر از جام زهر اتمی است. به همین خاطر همه باندهای رژیم در اعدام، شکنجه و کشتار وحدت نظر و وحدت منافع دارند. 10 ماه بعد از انتخابات نمایشی ریاست جمهوری و 5 ماه پس از توافقات اتمی ژنو، تحولات و روندهای طی شده در این مدت به روشنی نشان می‌دهد که 1. نمایش اعتدال آخوند روحانی شکست خورده است و شمار بی سابقه اعدام‌ها و حمله‌ها و قتل عام‌های وحشیانه علیه مجاهدان آزادی در اشرف و لیبرتی اثبات کرد که این رژیم کمترین ظرفیتی برای انعطاف و میان روی ندارد. 2. با استفاده از رویکرد بقایت ضعیف دولت‌های غرب، آخوندها هم برای شل کردن تحریم‌ها تلاش می‌کنند و هم با وقت‌کشی و فریبکاری به پروژه‌های اتمی خود ادامه می‌دهند. ممانعت از دسترسی آنها به بمب هسته‌ای فقط 1 راه دارد، آن هم برچیدن کامل سایت‌های اتمی در ایران است. 3. مماشات دولت‌های غرب با دیکتاتوری مذهبی حاکم بر ایران هر روز به مردم ایران و تمام مردم جهان لطمه می‌زند. ما از جامعه جهانی می‌خواهیم هر گونه رابطه و مرابطه خود با این رژیم را به لغو اعدام‌ها و بهبود حقوق بشر در ایران منوط کنند. 4. راه حل مسئله ایران تغییر رژیم حاکم بر ایران است. ایستادن در کنار مردم و مقاومت ایران و به رسمیت شناختن حق آنان برای تغییر این رژیم دیکتاتوری و همچنین تأمین حفاظت مجاهدان آزادی در لیبرتی، هم خواست مردم ایران و هم نیاز جامعه جهانی و لازمه حفاظت از صلح و آرامش در منطقه و در جهان است. دوستان عزیز، 3 سال قبل در 19 فروردین مجاهدان اشرف مورد یک حمله سبانه قرار گرفتند. 36 تن از آنان به شهادت رسیدند و صدها تن مجروح شدند. اما هنوز نه مسئولان جنایت در مقابل عدالت قرار گرفتند و نه هیچ تحقیقات مستقلی در این زمینه صورت نگرفته است. در فقدان چنین تحقیقات و مؤاخذه‌ای، حملات به اشرف و لیبرتی و خونریزی های بیشتر مستمرن ادامه خواهد داشت، کما اینکه ادامه داشته است. اما سیاست مماشات به رغم ضرورت و خواست مقاومت ایران برای تحقیقات در مورد این جنایت، مانع انجام این کار شده است و مجاهدان لیبرتی همچنان در معرض خطر حملات بیشتر قرار دارند. به همین دلیل جامعه جهانی باید به فوریت به آن بپردازد. I have come to the European Parliament to call on European people, parliaments, governments and other EU institutions to support the struggle of the suppressed people of my country for freedom. We have risen against a brutal regime which is the prime threat to human society, its achievements and progress. Unfortunately, due to economic interests and in the framework of the policy of appeasement, European governments have sided with the clerical regime in Iran. On the contrary, members of the European Parliament have echoed the conscience of the people of Europe by siding with the Iranian people and the Iranian resistance in their quest for change. The resolution adopted on April 3rd by the European Parliament, which underscored the violation of human rights by the Iranian regime, is the most recent initiative by the European Parliament. Mullah's anger about this resolution shows its effectiveness and importance. Yesterday, the regime's so-called parliament prepared an urgent resolution against the recent resolution adopted by the European Parliament. This reaction shows Mullah's lack of capacity for change or moderation. This regime cannot survive without hangings, torture, warmongering, and terrorism in the region. On the contrary, I can inform you that the people of Iran praise this initiative of the European Parliament. Previous initiative pursued the same line. Dear friends, 10 months ago, when the new president of the Mullah's regime came to office, the Iranian resistance rejected his claim for moderation. At the same time, you rightly rejected the claims of moderation of Rouhani, and by exposing this illusion and by your firm positions, you have not allowed those advocating appeasement to legitimize the brutal regime ruling Iran. In its resolution, the European Parliament emphasizes that the presidential elections were not held according to the democratic standards valued by the EU. Regrettably, Western countries maintain their inaction regarding the growing number of executions and suppression in Iran, as well as the regime's direct role in the bloodbath in Syria and Iraq. But despite the policies of the government, your firm and clear positions vis-à-vis the religious fascism ruling Iran and against grave violation of human rights have always been a deterrent factor against the policy of cooperation of Western countries with the criminal regime ruling Iran, and the people of Iran demand a firm position vis-à-vis the religious fascism ruling Iran. They want leaders of this regime to be brought to justice before international courts for crimes against humanity and not shake hands with them, as you said. During two recent months, Khamenei has actively formed a policy against the agreement. The mullahs have obtained an ease on the sanctions, but instead they have not stopped their nuclear program. Western countries must insist on shutting down nuclear sites and stopping enrichment of uranium. I warn that any concession or appeasement by the West will help the mullahs to obtain the bomb. On behalf of the Iranian people and their resistance, I warn that the Western governments must not sacrifice human rights and freedom for the sake of negotiations and their relations with the religious fascism ruling Iran. They must follow the European Parliament's April 3rd resolution, which has said human rights dialogue with Iran should be part of the future policy framework of bilateral EU-Iran relations. The regime is facing growing instability, the gap created in the leadership of the regime, as a result of the sham elections last year is widening. Their weakness and inability to deal with the growing crisis forced to agree with the Geneva Agreement, which has already intensified the internal crisis of the clerical regime. Iranian regime's various proxies in Iraq are further divided. The mullahs fear that this crisis leads to mass uprising against the regime. Therefore, they have intensified suppression and executions in Iran, which you have taken firm position against these violations in the resolution of April 3rd. At the same time, the mullahs carried out through its Iraqi puppet government the Ashraf massacre and missile attacks on liberty. They have also intensified the restriction on food and medicine in liberty and are paving the way for extradition of the PMOI members. The mullahs consider PMOI their existential threat, and therefore Camp Liberty is their prime target. Silence and inaction of US, EU, and UN has given a free hand to the mullahs and their proxies in Iraq to continue with their crimes. I call on you to ask EU to use its leverage in order to free the 7 Ashrafi hostages, immediately relocate PMOI members from Liberty to Europe and US, provide all protective needs of the residents, station UN observers and blue helmet in Camp Liberty while the residents are still at Camp Liberty, and refer investigation of the September 1st massacre in Ashraf to the International Criminal Court by UN Security Council. And finally, allow the residents to sell their properties in Ashraf through their legal representatives. These demands were underlined in a number of your resolutions and position, which reflects the demand of freedom lovers in Iran. Dear friends, allow me to once again express my deep appreciation for your courageous defense of Ashrafis and freedom and democracy in Iran. I thank you all very much.